connections. And the next thing you know, I'm sexting. It's very unsettling.
Ron, okay, let's get back on track here. We were talking about diversity. And they ruin American youth. They encourage all this bad thinking. Now, those kids that go to these colleges, they want to learn how to send better dick pics and cleavage pics on Snapmatic. If you want to learn, do it on your own. I'm not on my time. Order some books online, kids. Now, we have to push Congress to close them, pass the tax savings to the people, make this nation great.
Wait, the taxpayers?
Yes. The big taxpayers, exactly, or even better, scrap taxes. The country would flourish. Back to America, taxes are unconstitutional.
I have always thought that.
True. And we at the American Truth Institute, we love this country, and we love the Founding Fathers. That is why we want to change everything about this country, because we love it so damn much. We love our country. God bless America. God bless Lady Liberty. We the people. I love this damn country. I am fighting. I am fighting America. I am fighting for us. God damn it, love my country.
Sophia, is this heading into political
area? No. No, we are not. We're not political. Okay? We are renegades. We're fighting on horses, sort of like when I was a young girl and I didn't fully understand pleasurable rhythms and shoes, but I didn't long for it.
Under there now. take flight.
See these free fellas riding bicycles. City boys coming out to the country with their brightly colored jerseys and fruity hats and tight shorts.
I don't want to see your Johnson. We ain't friends. And they ride bicycles with tap shoes on. Fucking tap.
Your business and I will do the pontificating, sir.
Anyway, my kid is real good at sports, like football and that. I think he's gonna get a scholarship. He hits real good, real good, like one of the backheads you read about them picking up north. But my wife won't let him play because his grades are low on account of him getting his girlfriend pregnant. Not my wife. My wife can't get pregnant no more. Uterus is ravaged like the projects. Anyway, I need to make a lot of money by going pro so that I can get a new bass boat. What am I gonna do, Dwayne? I can't stop crying.
Brother, I share your pain. Let it go. Let it all flow out your eyeballs down to your chin.
kids keep his head behind the referee's back so he never walks right again? Stuff winners got to do to get the job done. How to cover up the smell of marijuana by blowing through toilet paper roll with dry sheets stuffed inside. How to leave a woman. I taught each of those boys the facts of life and how it is never about the woman's pleasure. Never. Absolutely never
it
about that
so
woman's pleasure.
It ain't so easy being a grandfather.
That's fucked up. I can't find where they moved the goddamn chronic factory to.
I don't give a damn.
We have more in the back.
Got a great deal there.
I think you made the right decision. I'm here to help.
Boyfriend is lifting Martina. If I catch him, I'm fucking killing everyone in this town.
Hey, you sure do talk some shit. Yeah, I'm seeing about three of you right now.
Shut the hell up.
Sickos calling up and ruining my otherwise flawless broadcasting flow. This is a civilized show for civilized people discussing a variety of topics relating and beyond insemination. Why, oh why, does this subject matter attract such a variety of perverts, creeps, and weirdos? It is quite beyond me. Don't get me wrong, I mean, I like a good time. I've been known to participate in a pheromone party where you do not shave or bathe for 1 week and then partake in moonshine and speed with a group of like-minded. It is hell on the other side of that party, but it is worth the ride. But that does not mean I find calling up a radio program about royal affairs pleasure myself while perusing the helper section of the information superhighway an acceptable form of behavior. Is that clear? Charlie, you pervert, is that clear?
Yes.
Are we straight, son?
Yes, sir.
Better than when she came in, that's for sure.
For the record, not me, nor no one in my family was up after a litter by eating their waste. My mom ate all her boys' poop till we were five. It was unconventional, but it sure made us the people we are today. Social services said this had something to do with the lab where my daddy had cooking up toilet cleaner. But I would ferociously even go as far as to challenge you to a knife fight. You want to come and talk some shit like that, we will turn our wrists together and solve this in the time on our way. That's what you're talking about. Get up on my show. Central nervous system, and you put the creature out of its misery. You ever have deer sushi? A little rice and wasabi and some fine loin meat, all served up on my stepdaughter just like they do in Asia. I am particularly interested in visiting Asia. I've always been kind to the Asiatic cultures. I've always enjoyed them, from kung fu to martial arts, fucking throwing stars. I'd really love to see Thailand, though. Somebody say ping pong? Just saying, not judging. Ain't my way. On my bed and a pool chain next to my mattress that summons a manservant to bring me another lager light. That's what success and a good work ethic can get you. And of course, top matches get a multi-award-winning radio show. Speaking of which, this has been Beyond Insemination. We didn't get this much romantic in blue. Big way. Trust me, we will. Be good. Good television. Fight artificial insemination. It's unnatural. Blasphemy. Until next time, Dwayne Earl, you are not.
You have been inseminated.
What's the greatest date in American history? The 1920s.
country's a piece of bullshit. Let's bring back the glory of the Jazz Age by recreating the conditions that turned America into a superpower. The noble experiment is worth trying again. Vote yes on Proposition 14. Bring prohibition and usher America into a new golden age.
96.5 FM, Blaine County Radio. The agenda of billionaires. Presented in simplistic, folksy terms so idiots are convinced to vote for us.
Oh, yeah!
There we go!
96.5 FM, Blaine County Radio. The Patriot, Xbox, Blaine County Radio. The queen of casseroles, extreme coupon, and dishing out the political dirt. It's Bless Your Heart with Bobby June.
Hello, hello! Oh, my, you little angels. Look at you, just so wonderful. You know, today we do give show a real doozy. Cooking, politics, homemaking, driving tip, sexual orientation, correction, quilting. Honey, we have it all. We really, really do. Bless your heart, bless my heart, bless us all. Now, firstly, we have a very special guest. A first on Bless Your Heart. You know him from some of your favorite stunts and some classic movies, including Nighthawk 5, The Mainframe, and 18 Wheeler Death Race. Honey, he has fought terrorism, he's jumped off buildings, and now he's doing something real crazy. He's running for governor, y'all. John Cranley. That's coming up right in a bit. And then, straight from my mama's kitchen, a recipe for lucky dip, ketchup, and meatloaf with a ranch dressing.
attention, now I'm really winning. We can pull the Maseratis out and whip the business. I was handing thousands out when I go shopping in it. When it comes to stacking cash up in